The upper part of the bag, along the blade's path, is cut to a length of about 3 meters. Back to the diversion valve. We set the lever to the roller 9 o'clock position, operate the hydraulic system and turn round the roller until the row of spikes is in the uppermost position. Should roller not rotate with hydraulics working, increase fluid circulation by turning the knob of the variable flow valve. The bag is opened wide along the slash previously executed, and we move back with the unloader until the sweep screws reach the grain. We first puncture and secure the lower half of the bag to the spikes, allowing it to hold some slack that will later bulge outwards and contain the incoming grain. The upper half of the bag is secure taut with no slack. We run the tractor's hydraulics. The valve selector level still in roller position, making sure the roller spins in the right direction, as indicated by a sticker attached to frame. The tractor, its gear case in neutral and without brakes, will be pulled along with the unloader as the roller rotates and hauls in the plastic bag. Simultaneously with the hydraulic action, the PTO is engaged and gradually revved up to 540 RPMs, providing movement to both sweepers and discharge auger. As the unloader advances, we must verify that the bag is being drawn through the cutter blade assembly. The variable flow control valve is located above the roller. By turning the knob, we control the amount of oil circulating through the hydraulic motor and therefore its speed from complete detention to maximum revolutions. Advanced speed of the unloader will depend upon grain type and condition and will be dictated by level of grain within the bag. The front of the bag should drop vertically to the ground as it bulges out. The grain height within the bag should stay constant, always remaining below the roller's level, and speed adjusted accordingly, both to ensure a smooth grain outflow and to prevent mechanical failure should grain be dragged up to the roller. The tractor's line of advance must be kept straight to prevent the unloader from swerving. Should unloader veer severely offline, it is better to cut the bag and restart operation. If we wish to conclude the unloading operation, this is how we move the machine away. A. We counter-rotate the roller by reversing the tractor's hydraulics until bag tension slackens. B. We then open the gear case's hinge cover and remove the two retaining bolts from the biggest sprocket to allow roller free play. Go forward with the tractor and bag will unroll. Finally, the bag is unfastened from the roller. We replace the bolts that connect roller and reduction gears and close the cover.